Hello, I'm Rocky Bowles. Today, together with John Schuler, Applications Engineer, we're gonna go over one of the really great benefits of the VOYAGER XP saw. John, what do you got in store for us today?
So today we're gonna be looking at and showing you the value of TightCut. So TightCut is a feature that's only seen on the VOYAGER XP, and the benefits of it is it allows us to get tighter nesting of parts onto a slab, which is more material yield. Less incremental routing is gonna be involved with the TightCut. And there's not going to be any park pauses in between to get parts off the table to finish off another part.
Fantastic. John, can you show me, maybe show us how this works exactly?
Yeah. So to dive into a little more detail, as a blade is traveling and it's coming up to another part, that blade will stop and it'll actually plunge down into the concrete table here using the edge of the blade to finish off this piece. So there we're leaving about a 1-inch gap from piece to piece or part to part.
So John, with this technology, it'd be pretty easy to turn maybe a 2-slab job into a 1-slab job?
Yes.
And we're gonna pretty much eliminate blade over travel, correct?
Exactly.
Right. You got something in your program you're gonna run for us today?
Yeah. Let's take a look.
Let's go take a look. All right, John, why don't you show us the program that we're gonna walk through today on the VOYAGER XP?
Sure. So what we have over here, we have number 1, 2, 3 parts. And what we're gonna see is a few tight cuts in areas over here inside of our sink and this inside corner here. And then we're gonna have incremental routing just to finish off these radiuses inside.
Now, John, would this be typically on a standard bridge saw, would this be a 2-slab job? Is this a good example of that?
It'd be a lot easier if it was a 2-slab job. On a bridge saw, you can get it in 1-slab as well, but there's gonna be a lot more interruptions. And those interruptions would be moving parts off the table, getting them out of the way. So with the VOYAGER and the tight cut feature, we can leave everything there. We hit cycle start and we can walk away. On your bridge saw though, we would have to either move cut number 1, move it off the table, and then finish 2 and 3, or vice versa. Cut 2 and 3 first, move them off the table, do number 1.
So really with the value of the tight cut, we're speeding up the process, we're making it simpler, and we're also getting more yield out of our material.
Exactly.
Thanks for walking us through that program. Let's go take a look and watch the VOYAGER XP do its work.
All right.
All right, guys, we're gonna start out with the VOYAGER XP doing the incremental routing. And now we're really gonna be able to see the value of the tight cut and the limited amount of incremental routing that the VOYAGER is gonna have to do. This is really gonna speed up the cycle time and the processing time of all your jobs. You can see in the overhead shot here that the incremental routing is just an inch or two either direction, very limited, because we're going to be able to finish these pieces off with the tight cut and get right in there. So we don't have to do much incremental routing, which is really going to speed up the processing time of the slab. All right, you can see that the VOYAGER XP made quick work of the incremental routing, and now we are gonna get on to the cutting part of it. 27 horse arbor on the VOYAGER XP. It's gonna cut through any material, including your hard to cut materials, with ease. Another great feature that's gonna speed up processing time. No worries about hard to cut materials with the VOYAGER XP. Pay close attention, you'll be able to see it come in and it's gonna do its first tight cut here. This is the blade plunging down into the table, bringing those nested pieces in, making that nice clean cut for us. And then it'll jump back up here and then we're off to the next cut. What we're running is a 16-inch blade. Here we show the VOYAGER doing a tight cut. This is how we're able to nest these pieces in tight together, turning some of those 2-slab jobs and maybe a 1-slab job. And you're gonna see it come in, do the tight cut, no need to stop, no need to pause, no need to move pieces, just keep producing. Quite a few cuts in this job, so we'll speed it up. But you can see that The Voyager is going to be able to do all the tight cuts here, the nesting of the pieces, cut through this material with ease, and do a nice clean job. You're going to see the Voyager XP come up and do its first cut for the inside of the L. It's going to come in and hit that portion that we've already incremental routed out. The blade and the incremental router, the transition is going to be perfect. It's going to come right into it, leaving you with a nice radius corner on the inside. Then it's going to go back out and do another cut, which is going to be the other piece of this program. Maybe that's a center island, maybe that's part of a vanity, maybe it's something else that's involved with this project. Software knows right out of the gate what it can do with the blade, what it needs to do with incremental routing, making it very easy to program this. So we can see as it does its second cut, finishing this, the other part of the program, how tightly we were able to nest these pieces off, really showing off the value of the tight cut technology on the Voyager XP. After we get those pieces cut, then we'll drop back in and we will cut our sink out. Here you can see in the sink the value of the tight cut, the small incremental routed portions that we had to do, and the tight cut being able to come in, plunge into the table and finish that sink off, knocking it out really quick. Here we got the Voyager finishing off the sink. You can see the four corners that are routed out. Again, the small amount of incremental routing that was had to be done. So the Voyager is just going to come in, do the tight cut, and getting that sink knocked out for you. Here, this last piece we're going to do is going to be an example. We'll be able to, when this program's finished, show you exactly how tight the tight cut will get into a corner, basically making it very simple to finish off an inside corner if you choose to do it that way. Keep in mind the Voyager XP is an excellent mitering machine as well. We're not showing that in this video, but this machine does miters beautiful. With the Voyager, you're able to walk away and let the machine just do its job. So any of you manual bridge saw owners out there, when you think about, you know, going digital, the transition is actually quite simple and you are able to run this machine manual. But once we show you how to program it and run it, you're never going to run it manual. It's unitized design. It's one piece construction. This machine isn't shipped in several pieces and bolted together on site. This makes for a strong base that reduces vibration, really makes for a nice true machine. John, show us what we got here.
All right, Rocky. So in our square sink here, we have minimal amounts of incremental routing. On our L-shape piece here, you can see the tight cut feature allowed us to get really close to the inside corner here. And the incremental router basically just did the radius there on both pieces. You can see how close we nested our parts here. Parts 1, 2, and 3, there's about a 1-inch gap there, and these pieces are cut out completely. I have a sample piece on this side here I can show you.
Great.
Just how close we can get with that tight cut. So no incremental routers involved in here, but this is all blade.
So nice tight into the corner, basically just a little bit of finish work and you got a 90 degree.
Yep.
Thanks for joining us today. If you'd like to learn more about the Voyager XP and other great features and other great products we have available here at Park Industries, please reach out to us.